And I'm Jeff Olson, live at Calvary Lutheran Church in Golden Valley, where the mission is to bring 1 million meals to the children of Haiti. And we're not whistling while we work, but we are singing.
Chicken, veggie, soy, and rice. It's so nice, we'll say it twice. Chicken, veggie, chicken, veggie, chicken, veggie, soy, and rice.
Yeah. Woo! We're back with the story in just a minute on Care 11 News First Edition.
This morning in Take Care of Your Community, an update on the work at one Twin Cities church that hopes to bring 1 million meals to the people of Haiti.
The food packout is a week-long event that was actually planned prior to last week's earthquake. The packing started last Saturday at Calvary Lutheran Church in Golden Valley and continues the rest of the week. Care 11's Jeff Olson's there with this morning with an update on this huge effort. You got a lot of friends there, don't you, Jeff?
We do. These are the Uber volunteers from Calvary Lutheran Church in Golden Valley. Take a look. They're on the assembly line putting together these manna packs. And as you heard earlier, it's a mixture of soy and rice and other ingredients. They put them together and seal them up, and then they're put into boxes, and they're headed for Haiti. I'm going to bring in Pastor Steve Dornbush from the church here. I'm going to take him off the assembly line for just a moment so we can find out about this effort. You're about 600,000 meals into this 1 million meal effort?
We are, and it's been tremendously gratifying. People have come together in just amazing ways. Yeah.
And your church members have been to Haiti. They know that this country is ill-equipped to handle any emergency, much less this earthquake.
Right. We've had a number of people. In fact, if you go out in our atrium, you see pictures of kids. So these are actual pictures of kids that we've come to know down in Haiti. Some of our members have worked in orphanages, some of the medical facilities. And so it's a very personal thing for a lot of people. But you're absolutely right that even before the earthquake, the need was tremendous. And now it's, of course, grown exponentially.
We have some video from folks who were volunteering yesterday. Tell me about this unifying effort. You say it's one of the best you've done for this church.
Well, it's one of the things that just about anybody can do, from the very young to the very old. We've had people in their 80s, almost 90 years old, who have come to work in the line. Little kids have come with their pennies and nickels to try to contribute and be a part of it. They get in line, they feel like they're doing something really important, they feel like they're actually doing something with their hands, and they leave with a sense of accomplishment and knowing they've literally saved lives.
Very good. Pastor Liz is right behind you. She wants you to get back in line,
right.
So we'll let you go back to work. I want to say, too, that Pastor says that they don't need any more volunteers for this effort. But they do need money, and we'll tell you about that in just a moment. First, I want to bring in Jess Swanson from Feed My Starving Children to explain that you will either go to the volunteers or they can come to you.
Absolutely. We have 3 permanent locations here in Minnesota that you can come to, as well as 1 in Chicagoland. But if that doesn't work for you, we'll come to you as well with these mobile pack events. And we've been all over the country doing events with churches, schools, businesses.
And people wonder about getting food in quickly. Your organization was in Haiti prior to the earthquake, so you have arteries into this country already.
Yep, we have over 200 partners that are already in Haiti, established organizations. And as soon as those ports open up, we're getting that food there. There's already food being distributed through there that they've had in storage, that they're distributing across the country to people in need. But then as soon as those ports open, we've got so many more meals already waiting to get to those people as well.
Speaking of the meals, their manna packs, explain to me how these work.
Yeah, in each of these bags, we have 4 different ingredients. Chicken flavoring that has 20 vitamins and minerals. It's actually an artificial chicken flavoring. Veggies, carrots and potatoes for fiber. Soy is a source of protein, and rice is a source of carbohydrates. So it's really a fortified meal. It's healthy, it's nutritious, it's really the daily needs of a kid.
Right, and we should say too, if people are watching and they're thinking, I want to get involved, you say go through the website, don't just show up at a location.
Correct, absolutely. Go through our website, www.fmsc.org, and it has all of the locations and calendars for you to sign up for a time there.
All right, Jess, I'll let you get back to work this morning here at Calvary Lutheran Church. I want to tell you again that this effort right now has all the volunteers it can handle, but Kim and Tim, if you'd like to be part of this, each one of the manna packs costs 17 cents, so the church, in doing 1 million meals, is hoping to raise $170,000. We have information already posted on care11.com. Go to Take Care of Your Community and join this effort. When we say take care of your community, this is exactly what we're talking about.
Jeff, those people, the spirit and the attitude, how long has this group been working this particular shift?
They actually, Kim and Tim, got up early, especially for us, to pack. They normally do this during the morning and the afternoon, but they said, you come on down with your camera, we'll bring the volunteers and the spirit, and they delivered on that promise.
And they'll get that many more meals done.
Absolutely. I don't know how many so far, but it's hundreds already.
Great. Yeah, we can't thank them enough. Thank you, Jeff.
Thanks, Jeff.
You bet.
Yeah,
I wanted to do something tangible.
Barbara Bowman.
Instead of sitting at home feeling helpless.
Had seen enough suffering over the last several days, and she rolled up her sleeves to help pack meals headed for earthquake-ravaged Haiti.
It's okay to write a check. You know that gets put to work, but there's a certain amount of helplessness watching the devastation at home and just feeling like I got to do something. And, you can't hop on a plane and go down there, and you can do this. And it feels good.
It's pretty amazing.
This effort at Calvary Lutheran Church in Golden Valley is organized by the nonprofit Feed My Starving Children.
So we have over 200 partners in Haiti.
The group provides the four meal ingredients: chicken flavoring packed with 20 vitamins and nutrients, dehydrated vegetables, soy mix for protein, and rice. Volunteers are tasked with filling the plastic bags. Once on the ground, the contents just need to be boiled. Amazingly, each packet contains enough for six meals.
We use rice because it's a universal grain, so no matter where we send the food in the world, people know how to cook it.
Kids who are malnourished need one cup of this a day to survive, and their systems can't handle more than a cup of it a day.
Calvary Lutheran has some experience with the children of Haiti. The church has a mission that tends to a local orphanage on the poor island nation. These photos are being used to motivate the volunteers.
This means that 1,000 meals have been packed. The hearts mean that we've received $170, which pays for 1,000 meals.
It's a lot of fun. It's very high energy.
33,696 meals.
And it's just, it's a very neat thing to be a part of, to have people come and volunteer and to pack the food and to be able to send it to these children that really need it.
Some 5,000 people have signed up for this food packout over the next 7 days.
It's a small part of what you can do to help out.
The goal? 1 million meals, and already the boxes and pallets are filling up and being hauled away. The food is bound for Haiti and can't arrive soon enough.